As consumers, we buy millions of products every year, and just like us, these products have a life cycle. Older, longer established products eventually become less popular, while in contrast, the demand for new, modern goods usually increases rapidly after they're launched. Because most companies understand the different product life cycle stages and that the products they sell all have their own limited lifespan, the majority of them will invest heavily in a new product development in order to make sure that their business will continue to grow. You never want to only rely on existing products. Hold on here. Okay. The product life cycle has four very clearly defined stages, each with their own characteristics, and that means different things for businesses that are trying to manage the life cycle of their particular products. The introduction stage is at the beginning. This stage of the cycle could be the most expensive for a company launching a new product. You'll see the profit line in blue here, and sales revenue in purple. The size of the market for the product is small in the introduction stage, which means that sales are low, and although they will be increasing, it might not happen right away. On the other hand, the cost of things like research and development, consumer testing, and marketing needed to launch the products is very high in this stage, especially if it's in a competitive sector. The next stage is the growth stage. That's right here. The growth stage is typically characterized by a strong growth in sales and profits. And because the company can start to benefit from economies of scale and production, the profit margins as well as the overall amount of profit will increase. This makes it possible for businesses to invest more money in the promotional activity to maximize the potential of this growth stage. After the growth stage, we reach the maturity stage. During the maturity stage, the product is established, and the aim for the manufacturer is now to maintain the market share that they have built up. This is the time that it is most competitive for products and businesses because they need to invest wisely in any marketing they undertake. They also need to consider any product modifications or improvements in the production process that might give them a competitive advantage. After the product has matured, it reaches the decline stage. Eventually, the market for a product will start to shrink, and this is what's known as the decline stage. The shrinkage could be due to the market becoming saturated. This means that all the consumers who will buy the product have already purchased it, or it could be because the consumers are switching to a different type of product. While this decline may be inevitable, it may still be possible for companies to make some profit while switching to less expensive production methods and cheaper markets. Here's an example of watching recorded television and the various stages in each method. If we were going to be thinking of the introduction stage, we would be viewing 3D TVs. They are in the introduction stage. Blu-ray discs and DVRs are currently in the growth phase, while DVDs are in the maturity stage. Think to yourself, what is in the decline stage? Good old video cassettes are in the decline stage. Product of my youth, makes me sad. Anyway, the idea of the product lifestyle has been around for some time, and it is, the idea of the product life cycle has been around for some time, and it is an important principle that manufacturers need to understand if they're going to make profit or if they're going to stay in business. However, the key to successful manufacturing is not just understanding the life cycle, but also proactively managing products throughout their lifetime, applying the appropriate amount of resources and sales and marketing strategies, depending on what stage the products are in their cycle.